So John Dee was a polymath, and one of his interests was cryptography, the science of code making and code breaking. Now, that's one of my interests as well. So it's great to be able to see John Dee's collection. And in particular, there's a book called Polygraphia by Trithemius, which is a landmark book in the history of encryption. Because for obvious reason, people who had ideas about encryption didn't document them. You wanted to keep your ideas secret so that you could break other people's secrets. But this is a lovely book. It's not just important, but it's clever. There are things called cipher wheels or cipher disks, where you can put the letters of the plain text, what you want to write, around the outside of the wheel, and on the inside of the wheel are the symbols or letters you're going to encode into. And then you can rotate the wheel according to how you're going to encrypt your message. Now, the book actually contains cipher wheels embedded within the pages. It's done seamlessly. And if you see the exhibition, you'll see the book open to a page where there is a cipher wheel there. It's a beautiful book, but it's not actually the first book about encryption. That was written by an Arabic mathematician or philosopher, a chap called Al-Kindi. And about 1,000 years ago, in Baghdad, he wrote a book which was the first book or the first document that explained how you would break a code. And Al-Kindi said, typically the way you encode something is you swap a letter for a symbol. So you swap A with a square, B with a triangle, and so on. Now, Al-Kindi said that if you swap E with a cross, now E is very common. So the cross will be very, very common if your message is in English, say. Then you can use what's called frequency analysis. The most common symbol must be an E. The second most common symbol is probably a T. The third most common symbol is probably an A. If one symbol always follows another symbol, then that must be Q and U, things like that. If you have three symbols in a row very often, then that's probably THE, which is the most common three-letter word in English, and so on. So using this frequency analysis of individual letters, pairs of letters or three letters in a row, you can crack these codes very, very rapidly. So by the time we get to John Dee's era and the Elizabethan era of spies and plotting and intrigue, codes have become a bit more advanced. You see people suggesting that, instead of swapping E with a cross, swap E with a variety of symbols. If you swap E with 13 different symbols, E occurs about 13% of letters in English are E's. So if you represent them with 13 symbols, then each symbol only appears 1% of the time, and you're flattening out the pattern. You're getting rid of the spikes that would be obvious to a code breaker. So those are the kind of things that were happening during the Elizabethan era, the sort of things that would have interested John Dee. You can see how important code making, code breaking is in this era by looking at the story of Mary, Queen of Scots. Mary, Queen of Scots was a Catholic. She wanted to take the English throne away from Elizabeth. Elizabeth knew this, so she imprisoned Mary to keep her out of the way, keep her out of trouble. But even while Mary was in prison, she was plotting to overthrow Elizabeth. She was writing secret messages, encoded, which she would smuggle out in beer barrels to her conspirators, people like Babington. And Babington was trying to encourage a plot from Spain, an invasion from Spain, and ultimately put Mary on the throne. And that's what was written in these letters that Mary was smuggling out to Babington. So when these messages were intercepted, they were given to Elizabeth's chief codebreaker, a chap called Thomas Phillips. Phillips broke the code very easily because Mary was using actually a very old-fashioned simple form of cipher. The messages were decoded. Elizabeth was presented with the evidence that Mary was plotting treason. Mary was put on trial. She was found guilty on the evidence of these coded letters. And then she was executed in 1587. So you can see how the making and breaking of codes is a matter of life and death.